With Crysis 3, we set out to, as I promised, to meltdown the PCs, right? And I meant the PCs, but we also actually meltdown the consoles as well. And Crysis 1, it was designed to be a future-proof game. That means in 2007, when you played the Crysis the first time, you couldn't max out. You needed effectively the highest of the highest end GPUs. And for another 2-3 years later, you could still upgrade your PC effectively and you would barely max it out. And only after 2-3 years, at the end of it, you would max it out and get an amazing game that would never get old. On consoles, you can't make a future-proof game simply because the console is what it is. The PC is a future-proof platform. So we hope that the next generation of AMD platforms is going to really help gamers to max out and maximize the gaming experience from the PC platform.
We're really excited about the patches that we've got coming up. We're doing a bunch of gameplay balancing, particularly on the multiplayer side. We have some AMD features coming. We're looking forward to Eyefinity. We're looking forward to a kind of HD3D. We've worked with the AMD people to kind of get those features in. The benefits to gamers of playing kind of Crysis 3 in Eyefinity, it's a great way to see it. You know, we put such a lot of effort into the environment, into the way that the game kind of looks. Just that moment when you kind of come into a zone, you kind of see, you kind of stand and you look, and you've got this kind of great vision. Normally you're kind of looking down onto the level ahead of you, looking kind of from the dam into the canyon, and just seeing that in the expanded nature of it is really cool.
We work together with the hardware manufacturers, and we try to take advantage of whatever hardware is out there. So with AMD, a number of our projects, we've been working with them on Crysis 3. What we try and do is figure out, you know, what will work best on that hardware, and then working with AMD to find the very perfect solution. And they can do some work alongside us and alongside our research guys. We always want to fill every ounce of silicon that's available to us. So as the hardware becomes more powerful, as AMD create and research more and new powerful graphics hardware, we'll be looking to fill it and use it and move ahead of it. I think what's critical is that, you know, a hardware company like AMD is a research company in the same way that Crytek is a research company in the games area. And research, it's really important that you share information as early as you can and you work together as much as possible so that, you know, you're predicting what's going to come out. If you do it right, then hopefully, you know, the new features that we're developing tie in with the new features that are on the hardware. It takes a while to develop these things. So as much as we can share our research, the better the end result is for the gamer.